of our God this morning. So we will be all reading this together. We'll be reading it all. So out of the darkness of grief and despair comes the message of hope. Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. We run to the tomb to see, to see for ourselves, and it's true. Christ is risen. Christ is risen. We hear a voice call our name, and we know our risen Lord is with us now and always. Christ is risen. Christ is risen. Thanks be to God. Yes, Lord. Let's worship our God this morning. Lord, you are worthy. You are risen. Thank you, Jesus. Stop our mess together, church. It's a happy day that our Christ is risen. This gives us hope. This gives us a future. Let's sing it together.
They say history says that you have rescued me. Sing it out. Jesus is so.
is put on incorruption. And this mortal, all of us, must put on immortality. So when this corruptible has put on incorruption, and this mortal has put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written. Listen to this. Death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is your sting? O Hades, where is your victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Alapahal po natin ang Panginoon. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Lord, as we come before you, as your church gathered this morning, we thank you that we are reminded of that Via Dolorosa, that way of suffering that you chose. Not your will, but the Father's will be done, and that you faced the cross. Thank you for that love that gave up everything for us, including your last breath. We thank you that because you fought them and won against them, we do not need to fear them. Because today we remember your victory. As we continue to worship you, listening to your word, listening to our choir, giving, fellowshipping, in all these things, we ask only one name be lifted up, be exalted, be glorified, the only name above all names, Jesus. In your name we pray. Amen. Alapahan po rin natin ang Panginoon. Let us remain standing as we read from the Word.
Day of the week, when the disciples were together, with the doors locked for fear of the Jewish leaders, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." After he said this, he showed them his hands and side. The disciples were overjoyed when they saw the Lord. Again, Jesus said, "Peace be with you. As the Father sent me, I am sending you."
Magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat. Good morning, everyone. We have more seats here for our ushers. You may direct our guests, our members. Dito po sa bandang harap, marami-marami pang upuan. So please direct them in this direction. Pakibati naman ang inyong katabi. Please greet your seatmate. And the greeting is, "Peace be with you." Wow. Ang kapayapaan faithful to stay with Jesus until the very end. The other 10 remaining apostles all stayed away from the humiliation of the cross. The 70 who were sent, the hundreds who were healed, the thousands who were fed, they were all done. Wala na po sila. No one wanted to be associated with Jesus for fear of what the Jewish leaders could do to them as well. Nasaan sila? Where were the apostles? John wrote that on that evening of that first day of the week, when the disciples were together with the doors, the doors were locked, bakit siya nakalock? For fear of the Jewish leaders. The primal feelings in that room with locked doors was fear. One could imagine them thinking, everything happened so fast. We had a meal, our master washed our feet, he prayed in the garden, he asked us to pray with him, but we just went to sleep. The shocking betrayal of one of our friends, the arrest, the trials, the beatings, then the cross. And now, our leader is dead, buried deep in a tomb. Will the Jewish authorities also come to arrest us? Fear of man paralyzes. Ang takot sa tao nakakapag-paralisado. Earlier that day, it was again the women, ladies, who had the first opportunity to see the miracle of the empty tomb. Special mention for all the ladies in the house. Can I see the hands of our ladies? Mula sa lola, sa mga nanay, mga dalaga, mga bata, all the ladies. Can I see hands? Higher po. Higher, the ladies. Okay, thank you. The ladies, except for John, the ladies were the last people who were with Jesus when he was on the cross dying. It's again the ladies who were the first. I think the men were still inside that door, inside that room rather, with that door's lock in here. Mukhang mas matapang ang babae. One of the angels told the women, "You seek Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified. Inahanap niyo si Jesus taga Nazareth na ipinako sa krus." Sabay-sabay po natin basahin, let us read all together. "You seek Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified. He has risen. He is not here." Asan po natin he has risen? "He has risen. He is not here." That is the triumph of Jesus against death. Death could not hold him down. Sabi sa awit, "He is the risen King." I'm trying to use my imagination. How did Jesus and death fight? I don't know how. What I'm sure of, Jesus was victorious over them. Before we enjoy the beautiful songs prepared by our chancel choir, let us return to that locked room filled with fearful disciples. The second part of verse 19 of John 20 says, "Jesus came and stood among them." Jesus passed through the locked door. They did not need to open it. His fearful disciples were gathered together, and the very first words that came out of the mouth of Jesus is, "Peace be with you." After he
said this, he showed them his hands and his side. Can we go back to that slide, please? The disciples were overjoyed when they saw the Lord. Wow! What a surprise! Jesus is alive. He fought death and won. He is with them again. Fear has now been swept away, replaced by joy. Both the greeting and the presence of Jesus brought peace in their hearts. Brothers and sisters, when Jesus is in the room, there is joy. When Jesus is in the room, there is peace. When Jesus is in the room, fear runs away. Amen? Kaya mahalaga po si Jesus ay nasa ating buhay para may kagalakan. Si Jesus ay nasa ating buhay para may kabayapaan. Si Jesus ay nasa ating buhay para makakakbo palabas ang ako. Jesus repeats the greeting, but as ako man, and this is where I will end. Peace be with you. Can you read with me? Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you. The first command of Jesus to his disciples after their resurrection, on their very first meeting, walang panunumbat. No need to go back to the past. No need to tell them what they already know. That they are fearful, that they left him, they abandoned their master. Jesus did not dwell on that. He had this word for him, for them. Peace be with you, as the Father has sent me, so I send you to be sent forth in many places outside the locked doors, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, they did. Brothers and sisters, Jesus is alive. He is not dead. Nasaan din naman yung amen? He is risen. He brings peace, he brings joy, and now he is sending also all of us to tell others about him, about his life, his death, and his resurrection. For this school year, we have 9 months left. I pray we will all go outside this church building and tell others about Jesus. In the streets, in our neighborhood,
Oh.
died and rose again. What will your glory be for? So that after bearing your name is the promise of the Lord. Thank you.
sing all the stanzas of this hymn. And of course, there's a story behind the lyrics of this hymn.